Tyler was born with a congenital heart defect. We had anticipated that at some point in his life that he may need a heart transplant, but certainly not this early. He went into rapid heart failure this spring.
He was very sick in our ICU and really facing certain death. Historically, we would have had no options to be able to effectively treat his heart failure, but our surgeons were able to implant a ventricular assist device in him and support his circulation while waiting for a transplant.
The physicians at CHOP took something that, first of all, was meant for adults and put it in a 27-pound child. And then, instead of putting it in his ventricle, they put it in his atrium on the right side of his body instead of the left side. So everything they did was essentially not what it was meant for, and it works beautifully.
That's allowed him to survive and thrive, and hopefully he will soon undergo a heart transplantation.
I was born with a congenital heart defect known as hypoplastic left heart syndrome.
Julia developed a problem where the blood that goes through the lungs doesn't pick up oxygen.
I started to feel more tired and worn out, and they actually said that I'd probably have to get a heart transplant.
We wanted to try to see if we could figure out a way to somehow reroute the blood inside her body without surgery.
Jack Rome sat and sort of puzzled through Julia.
We drew her anatomy, we did all this flow mapping and stuff. And we finally came up with a way that we could rechannel the blood flow.
He was taking bits and pieces of other stents and such that we use for other indications and putting them together in a completely unique way.
You know, a couple of months, her oxygen level was a little better, and a few months later, it was a little better, and pretty soon, high enough so that it's virtually indistinguishable from normal. And she got better.
And I didn't have to get a heart transplant. So it was pretty incredible.
She really is the embodiment of the successes that we've had in the past, the problems that we run into, and with creative thinking, how we can solve these problems.
If you really want to make an advance in a particular area, you need to have a continued stream of funding that allows you to work at it, and especially if you want to do really new things.
We have, in recent years, made incredible, important breakthroughs that nobody else has had in some of the most important issues affecting our patients.
We really need the support of philanthropy to make that possible.
People may not realize just how important their donation is and just how significant that is for us.
We can really point to patient by patient and innovation by innovation where their money is being spent and how it's being used.
Those innovations, those creative leaps, the ability for the doctors here to see a problem and come at it a different way opens the door for a whole new avenue of exploration.
Solutions for patients in heart failure from all sizes.
Therapies that would eliminate the need for heart casts or transplantations in the future.
Prototype devices and rapidly come to a position where they could actually be made and put into people.
Placental studies. Is there a point where we can intervene and maybe prohibit that heart disease from even happening in the first place?
How addressing the lymphatic system directly can really improve the life of our patients.
It's all theoretical until you're faced with a kid or a young adult or an adolescent who has this acute problem. And suddenly, you know, here is this child who's going to die. And how am I going to help them? What can I do today? Not tomorrow, not next week, not next month, but today. Because if I can't think of something, that's it for them.
Tyler's a perfect example of what giving an endowment to CHOP could be like, taking a child who is critically ill and allowing him to go home and be with his sisters and grow and learn and play.
I can't think of anything more important than taking a child who has a fatal heart disease and getting them through to live to be a grandparent.
What we've been able to do is give those patients hope, give those families hope, and give those families the assurance that we're going to continue to do everything we can for them.
Helping these doctors pave the way for more kids and more families, there could be nothing more important, in my opinion.
From the bottom of all the hearts we touch, from the bottom of all the hearts we work on, from the bottom of our hearts, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.